So thank you guys so much for joining us. I'm Gia. As you know, I'm one of the stars from Camp GoldieBlox, and I'm super excited to be diving in with you guys to find out all about the science behind our globbles and also about your adventures at Aquanauts Day. So first of all, to start us off, can you guys introduce yourselves and maybe you can tell us a little bit about what we're doing here today and why?
Hi, I'm Sydney Hamilton. I'm an aerospace engineer.
And I am Samantha T. Porter, and I am an archaeologist.
My name is Adele Luna. I've been trained as a physicist. So we're all three scuba divers, and we dove down here to the habitat. We're spending 24 hours under the water, and what allows us to become aquanauts is because actually part of the habitat is still exposed to the ocean. So we have a moon pool in part of the habitat, and that means that the pressure is higher in the habitat. So after 24 hours, our body reaches equilibrium at point of saturation, and that allows us to fulfill the definition of an aquanaut versus anyone who's on a submarine or just doing kind of a short-term scuba diving.
So today we're going to be making these Oobleck and biodegradable glitter-filled globbles, which are super cool. For the base, you're going to need some spoons, some cornstarch, water, a balloon, a funnel, and of course the optional things if you want to add a little bit of an artistic touch.
We had to actually make our own funnel, and this is important to science because...
Yeah, so sometimes you don't have the equipment easily available, for example, when you're 22 feet underwater. So instead of a funnel, we actually took a water bottle and we cut the bottom off.
Like a true YouTuber.
And this is not just something you do when you're an aquanaut. This is very much something you do in science all the time. Sometimes you gotta be creative and figure some stuff out on the fly. Oobleck is what we call a non-Newtonian fluid, and that sounds very fancy. But basically what it means is if there is stress applied to the fluid, or so in this case, cornstarch and water, it's going to behave differently than if there's no stress. So in the case of Oobleck, when you apply a lot of pressure, like hit it really quick with a spoon, it'll be solid. But for example, if you're just holding it in your hand, it'll be liquid and actually start tripping.
Are you supposed to add this in all at once, or is it more like slowly in parts?
I'd say it's better to do it step by step, because a lot of the time, right, you want to make sure you're not adding too much water or too much cornstarch. So if you're combining them a little bit at a time, then you're more likely to be able to sort of control how things come together and then get a better result. So, and another thing is sometimes recipes, you'll have to adapt depending on your environment. So for example, if you live on top of a mountain, your box of brownies might have some different instructions. Yeah. And right now we're 22 feet underwater. So, right, exact instructions that make sense on the surface might not make sense here. So by doing things a little bit of a time, right, we can make sure we're getting some really quality Oobleck for a globble.
Oobleck for a globble.
Oh yeah.
How's yours going?
Mine's going pretty good so far. I've almost added all the water in here. It's a little bit difficult to mix up because it's like getting solid almost, but
that's
like,
yeah, that's what it does.
That's exactly what's happening.
All right, do you want a spoon? But that once it's hanging out, it becomes liquid again.
Yeah, but when I initially it's hard, but then it just slowly,
which is when it makes it nice as a globule. All right.
How's yours looking?
Mine's looking pretty good, I think, now that I'm using spoons. We're getting a little better.
I think so. All right. We're going to be careful with the glitter here, because as those of you who use glitter know, it has a tendency to spread. Since we're in a special environment, we're going to be careful here.
We have special glitter.
Yes. So we have biodegradable glitter,
which is much better for the environment. So,
all right, we're going to just sprinkle a little of our biodegradable glitter here. All right. For a little sparkle, it matches my outfit.
This is a great mixture. So what I'm going to do...
Y'all. So yeah, it might seem like we're in the living room. We are, in fact.
So this is actually how we got in.
We had to have all this equipment on to come in here.
Oh, he's taking a picture of you.
wondering, since we are making globbles, is there any way that making type of fidgets and science experiments like globbles, does that relate to your careers or jobs in any type of way?
A little bit about, you know, creativity and being able to invent stuff. So as divers, we all have different body types. And when I started diving, you know, it was really hard to find things that were smaller to my body type. And so I started modifying my gear. So I wasn't going to let that stop me. And you shouldn't let that stop you. You know, you can find creative ways. So for example, this bag that I put on my leg, they didn't have a smaller strap. So I cut the strap, and I don't know if you can see, I stitched it up so it fit me. And that's part of it. Don't ever think that because the gear is not there for you, or it's not your size, you're not meant to be there, you can 3D print stuff.
Yeah, so another thing is when we were coming down, I thought, oh, it'd be really cool to get a first person view. And so right before coming here, I 3D printed this, and it sits on my mask. And of course, because it's, you know, you gotta, I made the mask and the
3D printed
piece.
Color coordinated.
Yeah. So again, like a lot of, especially in archaeology where we don't have as much money as some other fields, we sort of have to be creative and sort of make our own gear. And that's really important too, because right, if we're able to do that, that means we're opening up the field and more people can participate as well.
That is really amazing. That's so cool how you're able to be crafty and kind of artistic in a way while also being super scientific.
To add some texture to our globble. But it's actually working really well. Yep. As you can see, the spoon just goes straight through if you go straight through, it's easy, but when you hit it, it becomes very solid.
Yep, and we did a pre-experiment, and we found out that the balloons we originally got seemed to be breaking. So as to not get Oobleck over our lovely environment here, we're not going to be proceeding, but Gia will demonstrate what one would do.
Yeah, so I filled it up there, I tied it in here. There's some biodegradable glitter, which is super cool, and the Orbeez are in here. And then the cornstarch and water made the Oobleck. So it's a really interesting consistency, but super satisfying.
Yeah. I like that description.
That was so much fun. I had so much fun making these globbles and talking to you guys about your experience as aquanauts.
Thanks for having us.